If you want to buy an Apple M4 MacBook Air for lightweight and portable 4K video editing, in this video I have three recommendations for you at three different price points. Hey, my name is Matt Johnson, and I'm going to cover a budget option, a best bang for your buck option, and an extremely powerful beastly option that will handle a huge variety of videos that you need to edit. Sound cool? Okay, to save you time, I've linked down in the video description to the laptops that I recommend also because I respect your time like that, and I will tell you that some of these links are to websites where I found the absolute cheapest price. So I would definitely recommend checking all these links before you make your purchase. Now, if you want a powerful M4 MacBook Air laptop that can edit 4K video very well, while also happening to be one of the cheapest laptops that Apple makes, my budget recommendation for you is a very easy one. It's the base M4 MacBook Air that retails for just $1,000. With you're getting Apple's latest processor, which is a nice jump in power over previous years, partially due to Apple upgrading their media encoders and decoders with their M4 series of chips, which will make your editing and rendering videos even faster. In addition, Apple is finally shipping their laptops with 16 gigabytes of RAM minimum. If you remember from any of my previous buyer's guide videos, all of those older MacBook Airs started with 8 gigs of RAM, and I was always recommending the upgrade to at least 16 gigs for video editing, but here we are with the M4, and Apple has increased the minimum RAM to 16 gigabytes while keeping the same price, which is fantastic to see. Overall, this is quite a powerful laptop in a very small size, and I think you're going to be very happy with it for video editing. But that said, if you want to save even more money, first of all, please be aware that Apple has an educational discount that will get you this laptop for only $899. And you may be able to find it even cheaper on another website. Remember, I will link to all of the most affordable websites that are recommended for this laptop down in the video description. In addition, if you're looking just for a laptop that's ultra small that you could copy footage to and do some very light video editing with, I would also recommend looking at refurbished models of MacBook Airs from previous generations. Or Walmart still has a deal with Apple where they're selling the M1 MacBook Air, which to be clear is three generations old now, but you can still get it brand new for only $650. And there are a lot out there that are refurbished for less than $500. So considering that we're talking about budget-friendly options, I would still consider one of those if you cannot afford the M4 MacBook Air model. Now that said, let's talk upgrades. And this is where we need to talk about the best bang for your buck option, which, spoiler, also happens to be the exact MacBook Air that I'm holding in my hands that I recently purchased. Yes, I put my money where my mouth is with this buyer's guide, and I actually purchased this laptop that I'm about to recommend to you, and I've been using it for weeks now and absolutely loving it. So take it from me, this is a great option. For the best bang for your buck M4 MacBook Air, you're going to want to choose two small upgrades that make a big difference in the usability of this laptop, in my opinion. The first upgrade is storage, and you're going to want to upgrade from 256 gigabytes of internal storage up to 512. This is going to give you more space for your programs, as well as give you room to edit a few video projects. And more importantly, whenever you choose this upgrade to 512 gigs of storage, Apple is also going to upgrade the chip on the laptop from a 10-core CPU and 8-core GPU to a 10-core CPU and 10-core GPU. So for only $200, you are not only getting twice the amount of storage space, you're also getting a slight bump in your chip power as well, which feels like a really good upgrade to me. Of course, if you find yourself needing more space for video editing, feel free to purchase an external SSD. I will link to external SSDs that I recommend down in the video description as well. So as you can see, for $1,200, that is the best bang for your buck MacBook Air that I recommend. And like I said, that is the one that I've been using and I'm extremely happy with it. So please don't stress, just get this one and please subscribe if you want to see a full review of this laptop. I'm working on it, it's gonna be out soon. Subscribe so you can see it, okay? That said, I'm sure you're telling me now, Matt, I have more of a budget. Is there anything more powerful than this? What do you recommend? Well, don't worry, I have a recommendation for you. For this final beastly MacBook Air option, this is where things get a bit more complicated. To be clear, you could bump up the RAM to 24 or 32 gigabytes, or you could also increase the internal storage space of the SSD from 512 to 1 terabyte, which is honestly something that I have heavily considered doing because I found myself editing a lot from this laptop while traveling. But that said, here comes the issue that you're going to run into once you choose to spend any more money than about $1,200 on this laptop. And that issue is that any upgrade from Apple is going to cost you at minimum another $200. So let's say that you opted for 24 gigabytes of RAM or 1 terabyte of storage. Once you choose one of those upgrades and you go up to $1,400, you need to be very aware that I've seen the base 14-inch M4 MacBook Pro laptop on sale now for as low as $1,400 new, or even cheaper if you buy it refurbished. And with that, you're getting a slightly bigger screen, a fan, and overall it's going to perform better for video editing. So yes, I know this is a MacBook Air buyer's guide, but if you're someone that is only buying a MacBook Air because it's affordable, not because you want an ultra small and portable laptop, my beastly option recommendation would be to look around and see if you can upgrade to a more powerful 14-inch MacBook Pro with the base processor, RAM, and storage for not much more money. Now, if you want even more help with making your MacBook buying decision, I want you to know that I have another buyer's guide that I've put together all about the M4 MacBook Pros that I recommend for video editing. So I'll link to that video up in the corner and down in the video description for you to check out and continue your research. Remember, all of these laptops that I recommended are linked down in the video description for you to check out, as well as any accessories that I recommend for them, including external SSDs for editing, etc. In addition, how would you like to be able to buy them M4 MacBook Air for even cheaper? How does spending only $33 sound? What the heck, Matt? Are you insane? Well, hold up. There's a company called Get Upgraded, which I will link to down in the video description. They're not sponsoring this video or anything like that, but I am an affiliate for them, meaning that if you click their link in the video description and buy a MacBook through them, I get a benefit. Anyways, this Get Upgraded company lets you buy MacBooks kind of like how you can buy an iPhone, where you pay for your laptop monthly, and every 2 years you can upgrade to a new one. And what's better is that buying your laptop this way doesn't cost any more than it would if you bought the laptop outright with AppleCare Plus, which is super awesome. So you're basically getting to upgrade your MacBook every 2 years while paying less than you would if you just bought a new one outright every single time a new one came out. It's a great deal, and your first payment is only $33. And I totally would have used Get Upgraded if I hadn't decided to buy a MacBook Air at the last minute right before I left the country for 3 weeks of travel. So please check them out in the video description. I will also link down in the description to my edit videos like a pro guide. This guide is going to show you some of the most important things that took me years to learn as a video editor. And regardless of which video editing software you use, I know it's going to help make you a better video editor as well. You can check out this guide completely free at the link down in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe if you would like to see more videos about video editing in the future. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.